face, cut, bitch.
New month, new video, new city to explore, new vibes. We're here in Copenhagen, gonna be spending 24 hours here. We've just landed, we've arrived in the city center. We're gonna be spending all day in this awesome city. And then at the end of the video, we're gonna tell you how much time we spent in the city and how much money we spent. So without further ado, let's get right into it.
Right into what, my guy? Right into what?
Oh, you're not supposed to see this.
So one thing that you do as a tourist is Google what to do in Copenhagen. And one thing that you obviously go on is TripAdvisor. And the first thing that pops up is the most popular thing is actually right behind me, which is Tivoli Amusement Park, located literally opposite Copenhagen Central Station. And it is pretty, what you see is what you get, because in an amusement park, imagine a Danish version of Thorpe Park. So anything from rides, roller coasters, bumper cars, etc. Right? As it's closed for now, up until November 19th, due to the Christmas period, there's not really much to say. So let's keep going, but do come check it out if you're here during the Christmas time. Let's go. A big ass thermometer on the wall to tell you what the temperature is. Just the little things, I swear, that makes Copenhagen, Copenhagen. Let's carry on.
So views and vibes is exactly what TMA is known for, and this place at the Round Tower provides just that. As soon as you get to the top, you get a nice 360 panoramic view of the whole city. And what I love already about the place is they've made the corridor so wide that people can go up it and they can go down it with no issues at all. They do have a traffic light system, so it lets you know at what time you can go up and at very fast speeds, or they tell you, you know, when to wait and let people come through. So that's really dope. So yeah, come check out the roundhouse. On to the next spot.
Somebody said that's Voldemort's yard, bruv. Nobody knows why, but that's Copenhagen. Here with the facts. Anyway, fade out, fade out, fade out. Bye.
Thank you.
Copenhagen in disguise, Ganner. This is actually what you see. This is known as Nyhaven, a 17th century waterside canal, now known as the entertainment district here in Copenhagen. Now, usually I'll tell you all about the history, but I ain't gonna say anything more. Let the visuals kind of speak for itself.
Alright people, so here we are at Frederick's Church, the equivalent to St. Paul's Cathedral in London. Now, I'm not really here to talk about history, that's all vice duties, but we're here to appreciate the architecture and enjoy the visuals. So, let's do that, then on to the next spot. Where are you? Stop panning to me! You're supposed to keep the focus on the thing! Stop doing this!
What are you saying about astronomy?
It's the best thing in the world, invest it, not sponsored, but yeah, let's move on.
This is something that you've got to try. Peter's Bakery, established in 1652, one of the oldest bakeries here in all of Denmark and the oldest shop in Copenhagen, believe it or not. Their recipe, I'm assuming, is unchanged because they've perfected it for over 300 odd years. This is not a cinnamon swirl, but it's a cardamom swirl. I've never actually heard of anyone even trying that or doing it, but this is fluffy, amazing. All the verbs or vocabulary or synonyms of beautiful, think about it, that's basically it. But that's got a touch of and a side of that is nice, all right? Oh, I know we're trying bakery at like 4:30, and it's one of the things I find fascinating is the fact that at 4:30, it's still fresh. Obviously, when you go to a bakery, be smart about it, and it goes like 7:30, 8 o'clock. But to hear being at 4:30, 5 o'clock in the evening and still being this fresh, that is a recommendation like no other. So, bakery done, onwards to the next spot.
People, we are here at Tivoli Food Hall. Now, normally what we do, we usually go to a rooftop bar, kind of get a nice view of the city, enjoy the views and the vibes. But unfortunately, none of them were open when we got there. So we're like, all right, Vi's a bit hangry right now. We need to like find somewhere to eat and stuff. And we stumbled upon this place, literally right next to Copenhagen Central Station. So what I love about this place, you've got a good variety of different foods around here. I know, obviously, seeing as we're in Copenhagen, we're looking for something Danish, but you know, some days have a variety of different things instead of just what's the staple food here. So again, there's a lot of things to try here. Definitely come check it out. Cut to one of us for the outro back in London.
just like that, we are back in London. Stansted. Time check. It is now 12:15, the very next day, of course. All right. So in terms of, as promised, the expenses or the amount of money that we spend in Copenhagen will come up here. It's not going to be a ding. It's going to be a kaboom right here. And then the amount of time that we spent in Copenhagen will come here. Give me a sound effect.
Hiya.
Oh yeah! So yeah, that's the time and the money, and it always goes to show it doesn't take too much time or money to go to a city and have an amazing time. As always, don't forget to like, subscribe, comment and smash the notification bell, and comment down below on the next city you'd love us to visit, and we will make it happen. You know what time it is. ThreeManAbroad out, and peace.